This is the most mysterious guy you'll ever meet, the human brain. The human brain is programmed to be terrified by change. Why? Because as a lieutenant, it forms several behavioral tactics, ways to react in X situations, ways to react in Z situations. And that way, it forms a framework into which it feels quite confident to act within. Whenever something unexpected happens, it gets completely out of its comfort zone. It gets in a state of mind, of shock, and sets on the alarm. So, in the first place, it's important to understand that it is absolutely logical to react that way because we are structured that way. In the second place, though, what's also extremely important is to understand that as long as we keep having this alarm being on and on, the only thing we are going to succeed at is to weaken ourselves and to lengthen this inconvenient situation we have put ourselves into. What comes next? The so-called change of mindset. Our reality depends on the interpretations we make. Actually, studies have shown that our reality depends 10% on the actual data and 90% on the interpretations we make about them. So every time we face a change, we should ask ourselves the $1 million question, is there anything I can do about it? If the answer is yes, if I can do something about it, why not just to turn the alarm off immediately? You have ways to cope up with that change. You have alternatives. Why not just to turn it off? If now the answer is no, if I cannot do something about it, well, not everybody is meant to do everything, and it's okay. Maybe I have to take for granted that change and try to adjust everything around it. Or maybe I need time. I need to come back at a subsequent time, and it's also okay. No matter what, having this additional alarm barrier in my head won't help at all. The way we interpret data, the way we interpret change, affect the way we are going to react to it. The pandemic, for example, was an extreme change. It was a rift and a breakthrough into everybody's lives. We all felt the loss. We all felt the restrictions. Are there, though, any positive interpretations we can make about it? Number one, isn't it true that during the pandemic, we all reevaluated the real treasures of our lives? A hug, a kiss, a walk in the nature. In the era of staying home, the fact that we do have a rooftop above our heads and actually start feeling more and more empathy about the ones that do not. Number two, isn't it true that the last 100 years, and this only for a bit does not include the Spanish flu as well, the last 100 years, it's the first time we cooperate globally, and it does not concern a war. Because sadly, the last century, the only two other times we did so, it was for World War I and World War II. Number three, historically, after all huge disasters, after all big crises, after all pandemics, prosperity follows. Why? Firstly, there is the cynical data saying that people die, So wealth is redistributed to fewer people. And I'm not talking about the very few that will most likely always find their way. I'm talking about general population. And secondly, when people come out of such devastating situations, they realize they have nothing to lose and eager to restart. Through the readings we do, we influence our interpretations, and that affects not only our mental health, but our physical health as well, because anxiety and shock and alarm, they all transform cortisol into an intruder that causes inflammation to our system, among other stuff. We have to put more effort even to lose weight during stressful periods. So let's go from theory to practice. You're going to ask, okay, what are you doing? I have the rule of 3 days, and I'll explain myself. Whenever something sudden happens, I give to myself 3 days. 3 days to reorganize, to feel sorry about it, to cry about it, to get emotionally overwhelmed about it. For someone, this could be more days. For someone, could be even less days. But we have to put a limit on it. In case it has to do with people, either it concerns friendships or relationships that didn't work out, they didn't work out for a reason. Either you wanted it or not. That's the truth. And most likely, that reason was always there, or in any case, it is there now. Why keep living in the past and not enjoying the present, not dreaming about the future? Especially in the cases that we have the feeling of not being appreciated, or that we were consuming ourselves while being in those relationships, why keeping this self-consumption? Time is our most valuable asset. Let's take a look now at a case study. This is me in 2014. Apart from blonde, as you may all see, I was the commercial director of a TV business economic financial channel of Athens. I had, someone could say, wide social and professional network, but I was feeling there was something missing. I was feeling that a part of myself was not expressing itself the way I wanted to. I always had this inner feeling to protect the weak. I always treasured the value of giving, and I always believed that there is no one that cannot be a better version of him herself. So, in 2014, I took that first step out of those steps that usually frighten us towards the unknown, creating a space between, and I formed a team that takes care of homeless people. It started as something really, really small, but slowly more people became part of it. And I have said many, many times that I feel truly blessed for the charismatic people that that first step brought into my life. Today, our team counts more than 80 people. Actually, 20 of them are here in the room with us. We are in this together. And please allow me to seize the opportunity and thank them once again for this beautiful co-traveling, for sharing this beautiful journey, our journey, because it is our journey. We have accomplished things, but we want to do more. We have no ceiling. Sky's the limit. We want to become part of the solution of the problem. We want to be for those people, their contact with the society, in order to get their lives back. And we do have already established interpersonal relationships so that this is not a scientific function scenario. We can do it. What I want to say is dream big, but don't forget to appreciate all your little accomplishments on the way. The value of the unit is huge. After all, total consists out of units. Each and every single one of you can make a difference. Take small steps at a time, and if those small steps seem big, take even smaller ones. What's important is to have a clear goal, a clear vision, a clear direction about where you're heading to, and try to have a positive sign, a positive indicator in every single step you take. Even in the case of failures, you will gain experience. So, what's really, really important is to don't mind the gap, guys, of the space between. Cut it down to as many pieces as you feel confident with and go after your dreams. Future by default belongs to you. Go after it. And since we're talking about change, and my kind of field is such, I won't tell you to become the change you want to see in the world. I will tell you to become the people you would like to cross your path with. Γίνετε οι άνθρωποι που θα θέλατε να συναντήσετε στο διάβα σας. Thank you so, so much for this honor. Thank you.